clean.
You're already in the room. Now, you made me forget all our good news. Venla, just imagine. Last night, the stork finally visited your sister, brought her another little baby girl.
I can't wait to meet her, Mama.
Well, go put on a proper dress and take a hat.
Mama, don't be cross with me.
Don't be.
But I'm an aunt for the second time now, and I still have no idea how it happens. Please, Mama, I'm ashamed to even ask, but who can I ask but you?
Venla, child, you cannot imagine that I...
You cannot imagine that I still believe in the stork.
I honestly don't know what I've done to deserve this kind of talk. And on a day like today, go, child, put your clothes on.
And if I run out now and ask Gregor, the chimney sweep?
Very well. I'll tell you. But not today, tomorrow, or the next day.
Today, Mama.
Well, Bergman, I simply cannot.
Mama!
You'll drive me mad.
Why? I'll kneel at your feet, lay my head in your lap. You can talk as if I weren't even there.
Very well, I'll tell you. Child, I...
Mama?
All right. In order for a woman to conceive a child, she must... Do you follow me?
Yes, Mama.
For a woman to bear a child, she must... In her own special way, she must love her husband. Love him as she can love only him. Only him! She must love with her whole heart. There. Now you know everything.
Everything?
Everything. So help me.
Mama?
Mama, who bore me?
Continue his ear sheets.
Multa quoque et bello passus incondidet urbem.
Herr Rilo, from the beginning.
Arma virumque cano, troiae qui primus ab oris.
Herr Robo, and?
Italiam fato profugus laviniaque venit litera.
Herr Stiefel. Herr Stiefel. Continue, please. Herr Stiefel.
Lauvinique, when it.
And.
Litera multum enim.
Multum enim.
Multum olim.
Olim. Multum olim. So somehow the pious Aeneas has already suffered much in the days yet to come. Herr Stiefel. Do you have any idea what you're saying?
If you please.
Pardon me.
If you please, Aristonisich, can't we at least consider multum olim as a plausible conjecture for how the text might read?
Hegobo, we are hardly here today to conjecture on textual conjecture. The boy has made an error.
Yes, but an understandable error, sir. Indeed, if we could only entertain the fitness of the conjecture...
Multum olim!
Look to the fresh rhetorical balance. Multum olim, leading to multa quoque, a parallel, sir, between what Aeneas had already suffered in war and those sufferings on land and sea just ahead.
Hegabor, since the days of Cerberus, Aulus Gellius, Claudius Donatus, nay, since the very moment of Virgil's death, our world has been littered with more than sufficient critical commentary on textual conjecture.
With all respect, sir, are you then suggesting that there is no further room for thought or critical interpretation? Why then do we even—
I am suggesting no such thing. I am merely confirming that Herr Stiefel has made an error. And I'm asking, nay, demanding, that you amend his faulty text and proceed from there. Do I make myself clear? Hegabor. Hegabor, do I make myself clear?
Yes, Herr Sonnestich. Literat multum ille.
All of you, together with Melchior Gabor, laudinque, venit, literat
multum ille, et teis, iatatus, et alto, vi supera, saevae, memore, unionis,
horrific, dark phantasm.
You mean a dream?
A nightmare, really. Legs in sky blue stockings climbing over the lecture podium.
Oh, that kind of dream.
Have you ever suffered just mortifying visions?
Moritz, of course we all have. Otto Lammermeier dreamt about his mother. Georg Sierschnitz? He dreamt he was seduced by his piano teacher.
Fräulein Brusenhalter?
Moritz! I need hardly remind you that of all of our pupils, you are in no position to be taking liberties. I will not warn you again.
It's a bitch. Turn in your verses and clear away your personal effects. I will see you tomorrow, 7 a.m.
Well, I'm off. Me too.
I'll walk with you, Ernst.
You will?
We'll huddle over Homer, maybe do a little Achilles and Patroclus.
Home to Bach.
Fräulein Grossenbusenhalter will not be kept away.
Bach, Melky, 60 lines of Homer, all those quadratic equations. I'll be up all night again, and I still won't get through it. Try and sleep. Who can sleep? I'll just be haunted by another one of those dreams.
Oh, right, your dream.
Melky, why? Why am I haunted by the legs of a woman? A deepening conviction of some dark part of my destiny must lie there between.
All right, I'll tell you. I got it out of books, but prepare yourself. It made an atheist out of me. So...
No! Not here. I can't talk it. Do me a favor, though. Write it down. All of it. Conceal it in my satchel after gymnastics tomorrow. If you like, you could add some illustrations and margins.
Top to bottom?
Everything.
Unfathomable. Fräulein Knubeldeek.
Herr Knockenbrock!
Look at that. Melchior Gabor, a young man of distinct intellectual capability.
Thoroughly distinct.
A young man would be our finest pupil.
Our finest, Herr Knockenbrock.
And there he is, polluting himself, cavorting about with that
neurasthenic imbecile, Moritz Stiefel.
Thank heaven the upper grade only holds 60.
With a silk bodice and a satin bow in back.
Ooh, and then, love, what will you wear to Greta Rodenberg's wedding?
Mama said we can't go.
To Greta's wedding?
What, because she's marrying that forest inspector?
Well, it felt a little improper.
Well, I certainly hope your mama approves of the man I marry.
And the man I marry.
Well, we all know who Tail wants to marry.
And who doesn't?
He is rather handsome.
Mm-hmm. So wonderful.
But not so wonderful as that sad, soulful, sleepy head, Moritz Stiefel.
Moritz Stiefel? How can you even compare them, Melky Gabor? He's such a radical. Do you know what the whisper is? He doesn't believe in anything. Not in God! Not in heaven! Not in a single thing in this world.
They say he's the best at everything. Latin, Greek, trigonometry. The best part is, he doesn't care a whit about any of it.
In the midst of this nothing, this mist of a life, still there's this one thing just to see you go by. It's almost like love, sad as that is.
May he not be cool, but it's so
like I'm your lover, more like your ghost. Spend the day wondering what you do, where you go.
I try and just think, but then what can I do? Leave the bed, I jump. Am I jumping?
Have you prayed tonight, Desdemona? You don't look like you're praying. Lying there, contemplating the coming bliss.
Hunchin, you all right?
Yes, my stomach again, Father, but I'll be fine.
Yes?
Fine.
Well.
Darling, why? Why? Don't think I take your murder lightly. The truth is, I can hardly bear to think of the long nights ahead. It's sucking the marrow from my bones. Seeing you lie there, motionless, staring at me so innocently. One of us must go, it's you or me.
No, no, Gayo, please, again, and this time, bring out the left hand.
Why do you press your knees together, even now on the brink of eternity? Don't you see it's your terrible chastity that's driving me to...
Hunchin, that's enough in there.
Yes, sir.
Back to bed. Son?
1 minute?
Those soft white thighs, those cruel, cruel knees!
Repetez, s'il vous plaît.
Well, you'll have to excuse me. I know it's so off. I love when you do stuff that's rude and so wrong.
I love to my heart and stay in the heart. She loves something, give you a song.
October. The question is shame. What is its origin, and why are we so hounded by its miserable shadow? Does the mayor feel shame as she couples with the stallion? Are they deaf to everything their loins are telling them until we grant them a marriage certificate? I think not. To my mind, shame is nothing but a product of education. Meanwhile, old Father Cowbox still blindly insists in every single sermon that it's deeply rooted in our sinful human nature. Which is why I now refuse to go to church.
Melchior!
Yes, Mama?
Lord Stiefel's here to see you.
Moritz?
I'm sorry I'm so late. I yanked on a jacket, ran a brush in my hair, and dashed like some phantom to get here.
You slept through the day?
I'm exhausted, Melky. I stayed up till 3 a.m. reading that essay you gave me till I couldn't see straight.
Dear, sit down.
Look at me, I'm trembling. Last night, I prayed like Christ in Gethsemane. Please, God, give me consumption and take these sticky dreams away from me.
Yeah. With any luck, he'll ignore that prayer.
Melky, I can't focus on anything. Even now, well, I see and hear and feel quite clearly. Yet everything seems so strange.
My illustrations, they didn't illuminate your dreams?
They only multiplied everything 10 times! Now instead of simply seeing stockings, I'm plagued by labia majora and...
Well, here we are with tea. Moritz, how are you?
Oh, very well, thank you, Frogboard.
Mom, yes. Moritz was up all night reading.
Conjugating Greek.
Well, you must take care of yourself, Moritz. Surely your health is more important than ancient Greek. Now, what have you been reading, Melchior?
Goethe's Faust, actually.
Really? At your age?
It's so beautiful, Mama.
So haunting.
Still, I should have thought. Well, surely you boys are now at an age to decide for yourselves what is good for you and what is not. Well, if you need anything else, children, call me.
Your mother certainly is remarkable.
And so she catches her son reading Goethe.
I think she meant the story of Gretchen and her illegitimate child.
You see how everybody fixates on that story? It's as though the entire world were mesmerized by penis and vagina.
Well, I am. All the more so, I'm afraid, since reading your essay. What you wrote about the female, I can't stop thinking about it. This part here, is it true?
Absolutely.
But how can you understand that, Melky? What the woman must feel.
Giving yourself over to someone else? Defending yourself until you finally surrender and feel heaven break over you? I just put myself in her place and imagine.
Really? What it feels like for the woman?
fallen from the branches. What are you doing alone up here?
Mama's making May wine. I thought I'd surprise her with some woodruff. And you?
Well, this is my favorite spot, my private place for thinking.
Oh, I'm
no,
sorry.
No, 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 please. So how have you been?
Well, today was wonderful. Our youth group brought baskets of clothing and food to the day laborers' children.
I remember when we used to do that together.
You should have seen their faces, Melky. How much we brightened their day.
It's actually something I've been thinking a lot about.
The day laborers' children?
Our little acts of charity. What do you think, Venla? Can our Sunday school deeds really make a difference?
They have to, of course. What other hope do these people have?
I don't know, but I fear that industry is fast determining itself against them.
Against us all, then?
Yes, thank you.
It seems to me what serves each of us best is what serves all of us best.
Indeed. Venla Bergman, I've known you for all these years and we've never truly talked.
We have so few opportunities now that we're older.
True. In a more progressive society, boys and girls could go to school together. Wouldn't that be remarkable?
What time is it?
About 4.
Oh, thought it must be later. I paused and lay by the stream for so long, just let myself dream. I thought it must be later.
Well then why don't you sit for a moment? When you lean up against the soap and stare up at the clouds, you start to think hypnotic things.
I have been back before 5.
Won't you just stay for a moment? When you stare up at the sky, such a wonderful peace settles over you.
For a moment, maybe.
Just too unreal, all this. Watching the words fall from my lips.
Dating some girl with hypocrisies.
Haven't you heard the word of your body?
Certain dilemma.
Ah!
As we know,
The upper grade will only hold 60. I hardly think we can promote 61.
Hardly, Herr Knochenbrook, but let us look to the finals ahead.
Yes.
Remember, it is I who shall be marking them.
Then I am assured that the good name of our school is secure.
Shall we take the short way home?
No, no, by the bridge.
After 2 hours marching with that medicine ball?
Come on!
Someone wants to see, has Melky Gabor taken a raft out?
Last one there has to hold hands with conscience.
Maya, careful, your braid's coming.
Oh, no.
I'll just let it. Isn't it a nuisance for you? Day and night, you may not cut it short, you may not wear it down.
Tomorrow I'm bringing the scissors.
For God's sake, Bella, no, Papa beat me enough as it is. No, I was just,
Marta, where are your friends?
Well, when I don't do as he likes.
What?
Some nights, Papa yanks out his belt.
Where's your mama?
We have rules in this house. Your father will not be disobeyed. The other night, I ran for the door. Out the door, he said. Well, that's where you'll spend the night, out in the cold.
No.
It was so cold.
Oh my God. He beats you with a bat?
Anything.
With the buckle?
Oh my God!
Marcia, the welts, they're terrible! We must tell someone!
No!
But we must!
No, please, they throw me out for good.
Like what happened to Ilsa, you mean?
Remember?
But still!
No, I mean, just look at what's happened to Ilsa now, living who knows where with who knows who.
I just wish I could somehow go through it for you.
My Uncle Klaus says, if you don't feed a child, you don't love it.
That must be.
When I have children, I'll let them be free. And they'll grow strong and tall.
Free? But how will we know what to do if our parents don't tell us?
Marta! Time for bed now.
Father bought you.
You say time for bed, child.
27 November. The trouble is, the terrible prerogative of the parentocracy in secondary education.
Herr Stiefel, may we have a word with you?
A world where teachers, like parents, view us merely so much raw material for an obedient and productive society, a unified, military-like body where all that is weak must be hammered away, where the progress of the students reflects back only on the rank and order of the faculty, and therefore a single low mark can be seen as a threat
to— Melchior?
You.
I was lying by the stream, and I saw you here.
Yes.
So?
So, the stream, dreaming again?
I was, I guess.
And what were you dreaming of?
It's silly.
Tell me.
I dreamed that I was a clumsy little girl who spilt my father's coffee. And when he saw what I had done, he yanked off his belt and whipped me.
Bella, that kind of thing doesn't happen anymore, only in stories.
Marta Bessel is beaten almost every evening. The next day you can see the welt. It's terrible, really. Makes you boiling hot to hear her tell it. Lately, I can't think of anything else.
Someone should file a complaint.
You know, I've never been beaten. Not even once. I can't even imagine. It must be just awful.
I don't believe anyone is ever better for it.
I've tried pinning myself to find out how it feels, really. Inside. Like, the switch, for example. Tough, thin.
It'd draw blood.
You mean if you beat me with
it? Beat you? Venlo, what are you thinking?
Nothing.
I could never beat you.
But if I let you?
Venlo, have you lost your mind?
Marta Bessel, she told me!
Venlo, you can't envy someone being
beaten. But I've never been beaten my entire life. I've never felt—
What?
Anything! Please, Melchior! I don't feel it.
Maybe not with your dress on.
On my legs, then.
Vendla!
Come on! Please!
I'll teach you to say please.
You're barely stroking me.
How's that?
Marta's father uses a belt. He draws blood, Melky.
How's that?
Nothing.
That!
Nothing!
You better beat the hell out of you!
Come to this. I can't say I'm surprised. So now what are your mother and I supposed to do, huh? You tell me, son. What? How can she show her face at the Missionary Society? What do I tell them at the bank? How do we go to church? What do we say? My son. Thank God my father never lived to see this day.
Herr Stiefel. Moritz. I spent the entire day thinking about your notes. Truly, it touched me, it did, that you think of me as a friend. Of course, I was saddened to hear that your exams came off rather less well than you'd hoped and that you will not be promoted come fall. And yet, I must say straight away that fleeing to America is hardly the solution, and even if it were, I cannot provide the money you request.
I'm a man at a church.
friends at church, rehearsing for the Michaelmas chorale. I slipped out.
Yes, well, I...
Your friend, Mort Stiefel's absent. Someone said he's been missing all day.
I expect he's had his fill of Michaelmas.
Perhaps. You know, I have your journal.
You do?
Yeah, you left it the other day. I confess I tried reading part of it.
Just leave it, please.
Melchior, I'm sorry about what happened. Truly, I am. I understand you'd be angry at me.
Don't.
I don't know what I was thinking.
Don't.
But how can I not?
Please. Please don't. We were confused. We were both just...
But it was my fault that...
Please. Please. No, it was me. All me. Something in me started when I hit you.
Something in me too.
When I hurt you.
Yes, but still...
Please. Please. No more. My God. Just... You should go.
Won't you come out to the meadow, Melchior? It's dark in here. Stuffy. You can run in the rain, get soaked to the skin, and not even care.
Forgive me.
It was me. All me.
I hear your heartbeat, Ventla.
Oh, Melky. I don't know.
No matter where I am, I hear it beating.
And I hear yours. Melchior! No, I can't! We're not supposed to!
What? Not supposed to what? Love? I don't know. Is there such a thing? I hear your heart. I feel you breathing everywhere. The rain. The hay. Please. Please, Ventla.
Or dishonor our father and mother? In what ways have we
from all the wise instruction of our clergy, our teachers.
Are you all right, Benlo?
Buggers, Morin, so wild! so bohemian. All I want to do is dress me up and paint me. That Johann Fahrendorf? He's a wicked one, actually, always knocking down easels and chasing me, dabbing me with his paintbrush. Then that's men. They can't stick you with one thing, they'll try another. Oh, God, Moritz, the other day we all got so drunk. I just passed out in the snow. Just lay there, unconscious all night. Then I spent an entire week with Gustav Baum. Truly. Inhaling that ether of his. Until this morning when he woke me with a gun set against my breast. He said, "One twitch and it's the end!" Really gave me the goosebumps. But how about you, Moritz? Still in school?
Well, this semester I'm through.
God, remember when we'd all dress up and play pirates? Wendell Bergman, Melchior Gabor, you and I.
tell them. All the angels. I got drunk in the snow! And sang! Playing pirates!
We must take immediate and decisive measures, lest we be perceived as one of those institutions afflicted by the veritable epidemic of adolescent suicide.
Indeed, sir, but it will not be an easy war to win. There's not only the moral corruption of our youth, but the creeping sexuality of these liberal-minded times.
I couldn't agree more. It's war. Naturally, there must be casualty.
Naturally!
Bring the boy in.
Certainly, Herr Knochenbrock.
It would seem, young man, that all roads end in you. You do know what I mean.
I'm afraid that...
As well one would be. 2 days ago, after,
Moritz Stiefel!
Moritz Stiefel's death. The boy's father searched through his personal effects and uncovered a certain depraved and atheistic document, which made terribly clear...
Terribly clear!
...the utter moral corruption of the young man. A corruption which, there can be no doubt, hastened the boy's demise.
Without question, Herr Knochenbrock.
I refer, if you may know, to a 10-page essay entitled, coyly enough, The Art of Sleeping With, accompanied by, shall we say, lifelike illustration.
Herr Knochenbrock, if I could just...
Behave properly, that would be another affair entirely.
Entirely!
For our part, we have made a thorough examination of the handwriting of this obscene document, and compared it with that of every single pupil.
Sir, if you could show me but one obscenity, that...
You must now answer only the precisely stated question, with a decisive yes or no. Melchior Gabor, did you write this?
Did you write this?
There's a moment you know.
Thank you.
spells. So peaceful.
I know. When it's quiet in the evening like this, I like to imagine myself as a country pastor with my red sheep wife, my library, my degrees. Children from the countryside lend me their hands when
you
I go
can't
walking.
Be serious. Really, Ernst, you're such a sentimentalist. The pious, serene faces you see on the clergy, it's all an act to hide their envy. Look at it this way. There are only three ways a man can go. He can let the status quo defeat him, like Moritz. He can rock the boat, like Melchior, and be expelled. Or he could bide his time, let the system work for him, like me. Think of the future as a pail of whole milk. One man sweats and stirs, churning it into butter, like Otto, for example. Another man frets and spills his milk and cries all night, like Georg. But me? Well, I'm like a pussycat. I just skim off the cream.
Did you skim off the cream? Right. But what about the... What? Hutchin, you're laughing.
Come cream away the bliss. Travel the world within my lips. Fondle the pearl of your distant dreams. Haven't you heard the word of your body? Oh, gonna be your
bruise. Oh!
I know. When we look back 30 years from now, tonight will seem unbelievably beautiful.
And in the meantime?
Why not?
On my way here this afternoon, I thought perhaps we'd only talk.
So are you sorry, we?
Oh, no. I love you, Hutchin, as I've never loved anyone.
And so you should.
The young Baroness von Dilsbeck. 8 days later, I'm happy to say she's off to a spa in Piermont. breakfasting on roast chicken and new potatoes. So much, I. 3 days, an hour before meals. Within a week, you should be fine. Breakfasting on suckling pig, no doubt.
So that's all it is, doctor. Anemia.
Setu.
And the nausea.
Not uncommon. Don't worry. You'll be fine. Frau Bergman, if I may have a word.
Certainly, doctor.
Mama?
Fenimore, what have you done to yourself, to me? Fenimore!
I don't know.
You don't know?
Dr. von Brautenkofer said I'm anemic?
Probably. You're going to have a child.
A child? But I'm not married!
Precisely! What? Done.
I don't know, truly, I don't!
Oh, I think you know it! I'm going to need his name.
His name? But how... That? But how could that? I just wanted...
Bella, please, no more! You'll break my heart!
My God! Why didn't you tell me everything?
You were going to have to tell me who. Bella, I'm waiting. Georg Zerschnitz? Then who? Hanschen Rillo? Warren Stiefel? Melchior Gabor? Venma Melchior Gabor? Venma!
Thank you. And as that essay shows, he knew the danger of doing it. And still he went ahead, defiling himself and all but destroying that girl. So you tell me, Fanny, what can you do?
What you will. Reformatory.
Something has happened, Malkior. Something I can barely understand myself.
All right, each you animals put in a point. Reinhold will put it for the both of us.
I beg your pardon.
All right, you calm down. Reinhold, drop that.
Christ.
Rupert, erect.
Wait, what are you looking at?
Who?
The boy.
Oh, he just wants part of the sport.
Oh, no, thank you.
No, he wouldn't want to do anything.
Save him for something else.
What do you mean?
Oh, good girl.
Nobody talked to the poor boy with parlor men before.
He was too busy fucking his slut.
You shit!
Careful, razor burn.
Bastards! Check his pockets for money.
Yes!
Oh, what's this? A letter from this bitch?
Animals!
My dear Malkior, I only pray this letter reaches you. I bring so many and heard nothing back.
Hang on the perfect thing to grief the world. Son of a bitch!
From Berkeley.
Thank you for meeting me. Your name was given to me by a doctor friend. My daughter...
I understand. Follow my instructions carefully. This Thursday after nightfall, bring the girl to me. Gartenstrasse, number 11. The door below the tavern, knock three times and three times over.
But my daughter! The procedure isn't safe.
Each night, I have so many dreams of the better world we will build together with our child.
Chad!
He didn't know.
What a pout in a bitch, and he didn't even know.
Look at all these little tombs.
Look, a fresh one. Here lies in God, this Svendlerberg. Who are the died of anemia? Venla too? No. No! No!
Watch me. Just watch me. I'm calling.